हेलो क्लास 9, होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन विद योर फैमिली। चिल्ड्रन, आई नो दैट यू ऑल आर मिसिंग योर स्कूल, क्लास एंड योर टीचर्स ऑल्सो। एम आई राइट? यस, आई एम राइट। चिल्ड्रन, सेम प्रॉब्लम अराइजेस दैट सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट कम्प्लीटिंग देयर वर्क एंड दे आर नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग। इवन दे आर नॉट सीइंग, नॉट व्यूइंग द वीडियोज ऑफ देयर सब्जेक्ट्स। Earlier I told you that this is the hard work of your teachers to make these videos. So this is your responsibility to view that videos, try to understand that and complete your work. I hope that this time you will not disappoint your teachers. Hello class 9. This is unit 5B, input in Java. I have explained two types of using classes. Now this is the using stream class. To input a value by using input stream class, use the following steps. First, input stream reader class is available in java.io package. Hence, first of all we need to import this package by using the statement. When we start our program, that time we are using this statement. If we are using stream class, import java.io, io means input output. Second, in the main function, create object of input stream reader and buffer reader classes as shown below. Input stream reader read is equal to new input stream reader system.in. These two lines we will write. This is one line and this is second line. Buffer reader in is equal to new buffer reader read. These two lines we are using in the main function to create an object. The object names like read and in can be any word as per the user's choice. Suppose the different types of values can be input in the following ways. First, integer value. Integer means without decimal value. We are taking int n. N is the numbers. When we are input the data system, our println enter a number. Then data type is n is equal to integer dot parse in int dot read line. If value is in decimal form, then double n. This is the entering the number. Then this is the data type. N is equal to double dot parse double in dot read line. In place of integer, we will write double. In place of int, we will write double. Then float value. Float means fraction or decimal value. We will take int n. We will not take int n. We will take float n. System out println enter a number. Then in place of int, writing float dot parse float in dot read line. Next is character. Only one character, suppose a, b, c, any character. The data type, the value is char ch. This is only one character. First we will enter the value, enter a character, then we will write the data type. Ch is equal to in dot read line. This is the data type of this string. String, you know, a set of character or word, any word, sentence and set of characters. This is known as the string. String strs. We are taking a string str. System out println enter a string, enter a word. Then we will write the data type. Data type are same. Character and string data type are same. In dot read line. These types of data we are using in using stream class. Now next is using scanner class. Nowadays we are doing programming scanner classes. These programs you are doing. To input a value by using scanner class, use the following steps. First, scanner class is a member of Java util package. Hence, first of all, we need to import this package by using the statement. In that we are using import java.io, but in scanner class we will use import.java.util. or import Java scanner. We will take any one from them when we are using scanner class. Create object of scanner class in the main function. In that we are using buffer reader. There we are using scanner sc is equal to new scanner system dot in. Only this one line we will write. In that we are writing two line, but in using scanner class we are writing only one line. The value of different data types can be input by using next functions of scanner class. The different types of value can be input in the following ways. Suppose the value is in integer form, same we will write int n, system out println and enter a number. But data type we will write in there, so we are writing integer dot parse int, but in scanner class we will write n is equal to in dot next int function. Decimal value, value will double, and in place of int we will write double. Then float value, fraction or decimal. In place of int or double we will write float. Character, only one character, char ch, system out println enter a character. Ch is equal to in dot next line. The data type is in dot next line. There we are using in dot read line, but here we are using next. We are not using read, so that in dot next line. Same string or set of character or word, string str. First we will enter the string, after that we will write the data type. Data type are same. So I have written here a mistake. This is str, not ch, because ch is here. This is str. Now using command line argument. This is the fourth and last. This is one of the way to accept the data values from the user and pass the argument to the main function. While accepting the values from the console, console means we, users, the system stores the data values in different location as an array of strings. The data stored in the array of strings. To input a value by using scanner class, use the following steps. To input the value by using command lines, not scanner class, command line argument, use the following step. Use a string type array args. We are using args, not system.in. We are using args as an argument to the main functions. This is public static main string args or string then brackets args. In the both the forms we will write here. Okay, we can write string args and string bracket args. The different types of value can be input in the following way. Same way, if value is integer, then we will write the system out println same in all the fours, but changes are there in data types. Integer dot parse in args 0. There we are writing read line, but in here we are writing args 0. Then args 0. In place of integer, we will write double. Float value, in place of double, we are writing float, float, args 0. System out println character, args 0. Because this is the character form and str, args 0. Same here, we will write. Now, I am explaining types of error. Error, as we know, when we are running or executing our program, there are some errors are came which not complete the program and which interrupt the program. Thus we can say that when we run a program, then it may not get the desired result due to incorrect input data, and hence some errors arises. There are three types of errors in a computer program. First is syntax error. These errors occur due to the grammatical errors in the programming language. Mostly these errors are like semicolon, comma, terminator, colon. These type of grammatical errors are known as the syntax error. Next is logical error. The error which occurs in the programming logic is known as logical error. Logical error means, suppose we have not put this right logic, then when we are execute the program at that time, that logic, that wrong logic become an error. Suppose we in place of greater than, or in place of or, and, not, we are using simple languages, and, and, not, 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 we are not using their symbols, so that create a logical errors. Then three is runtime error. When we are executing our program, we are compile a program, that time error will come, that error will known as runtime error. It is a type of error that occurs at runtime when the compiler does not respond properly while executing a statement. When we are executing a program or statement, that time compiler does not working properly and it is not responding, this is known as the runtime error. Now next is command statement in Java programming. Comment statement in Java programming. Comment in a program make it more readable for the users. There are three types of comment. First is single line comment. Single line comment are used to write a single line message. A single line comment start with this form, these two backslashes followed by the message. Suppose for example, a program to find the sum of two numbers. This is the single line comment, and we are writing this sign followed by a message which we are doing in a program, so that by this message we can understand the program is related to which functions. Then number two is multi-line comment. It is a way to present more information about programs to explain the logic in details. A multi-line comment starts with backslash star asterisk followed by the comment lines and ends with same asterisk then backslash. Suppose for example, we are starting a program to calculate discount, then this is the only one in this is message, but this is the logic details. A program to calculate discount, it accept the mark price and discount percent as inputs, so that it explain the logic in details of the programs. Next is documentation comment. It is not a discussion about the program logic, but includes some text document. Means it is giving the information about that text document. This comment starts with backslash two asterisk sign, then followed by the set of comment lines and ends with asterisk forward backslash. For example, started two, we will write two asterisk here, not one. There we will write one asterisk also here. Author name Amit Kumar, then starting date of project, completion date of project, this is, then it will be ended by this, so that this is the documentation comment which are giving the text document information. This is the information of that document. Thank you.